You should already know that MongoDB is an open source NoSQL database that is gaining popularity each and every day. But why you should consider it in your next project and use it instead of a well-known, matured, relational, and structured database like MySQL? Well, let's start the debate. If you want to store large volumes of unstructured data, you should really consider a NoSQL database like MongoDB. Otherwise, you should deal with complex schemas, migrations, and schema changes over time. Comparison benchmarks show different results, and it is dependent on the use case and how the data is stored and organized. But in most cases, we can see that inserting data is faster in MongoDB because it does not have to ensure that the data is consistent with the schema. Updating data is also faster since MongoDB won't perform foreign key checks. Accessing data by an attribute is faster in SQL databases, especially when searching for an attribute that is unindexed in MongoDB. Indexing fields in MongoDB can boost the speed dramatically. Accessing non-keyed attributes are faster in SQL databases. But when the attributes are indexed as keys, MongoDB can sometimes outperform the rivals. You can have up to 64 keys in a MongoDB collection, so don't forget to index your data. Aggregation of data is faster in MongoDB. SQL databases are also faster in sorting. If you use nested references in your MongoDB collection, fetching and updating data is a lot faster than joining the tables in a SQL database. You should not store your data in a MongoDB database the same way as a SQL database if you really want to see a higher performance. MongoDB tries to use all the available RAM via the file system cache. It automatically uses all the memory that is not being used by the cache engine or the other processes. And this is coherent if you like to have the maximum performances. So, system resource monitors often show that MongoDB uses a lot of memory, but its usage is dynamic. If another process suddenly needs half the server's RAM, MongoDB will yield the cached memory to the other process. As a consequence, the single parameter that you can tune to optimize the memory usage is the engine cache size. If your data is going to grow unbounded over time, you need some sort of database technology that is not limited to the data that you can store. MongoDB can distribute the storage of your data across an entire cluster and scale horizontally instead of vertically. You should also consider your transaction rate. If you have thousands of transactions per second, one database system will not be enough for sure. With MongoDB built-in replication and sharding capabilities, your data storage and transaction rate can grow over time very easily and smoothly. MongoDB can be used from all major programming languages. But the software solution or stack that you're going to choose for your next app can greatly affect your database choice. If you want to choose Node.js as your backend, for example, the perfect combination is a NoSQL database like MongoDB, wherein the schema need not to be well structured. MongoDB represents the data as a collection of documents rather than tables related by foreign keys. This makes it possible for the varied types of data to be stored decently and accessed in a web application using Node.js. That's why the mirror or mini stacks are popular these days. Letting you write JavaScript for the client, backend, and database layer with its schemaless nature is a better match for constantly evolving data structures in web applications. Document databases put the developers in charge of the data. Data becomes like code that is friendly to the developers. If you are using modern agile technologies, a relational database will definitely slow you down. A NoSQL database doesn't require the level of preparation typically needed for relational databases. With MongoDB, there is less chance of SQL injection attacks due to the design. But external injection is also possible in NoSQL database management systems such as MongoDB. In most cases, external injections happen as a result of an unsafe concatenation of strings when creating queries. So, you still need to validate your data. If you don't have the time, budget, or the in-house expertise to face the challenges of managing a massive database yourself, there are a lot of managed MongoDB providers on the public clouds that you can choose from. You can set up your MongoDB cluster in a matter of minutes and add nodes when you need to. There are even some free options. If you are just in the development phase right now and your data size is less than 500 megabytes, you can even install and manage MongoDB on a free web control panel like CWP or CentOS web panel. The link will be in the description and more about CWP in a later video, but you need to make sure that you have someone available who knows what they're doing for setting this up in a secure manner. If you are in a smaller organization, maybe it's better to choose a paid option with professional support. MongoDB can be a better choice for social networks, real-time analytics and data integration, product catalog, Internet of Things, mobile apps, and gaming. As I said earlier, it is highly dependent on your data structure and application. But these are the common use cases. Reasons why you might consider a SQL database. If you need ACID compliancy. ACID stands for atomicity, consistency, isolation, and durability. ACID compliancy reduces anomalies and protects the integrity of your database. It does this by defining exactly how transactions interact with the database, which is not the case with NoSQL databases, which have the primary goal of flexibility and speed, rather than 100% data integrity. If your data is structured and unchanging, if your business is not growing exponentially, there may be no reasons to use a system designed to support a variety of data types and high traffic volume. If you need stored procedures. In MongoDB, there is not any provision for a stored procedure or functions or trigger. So, there are no chances to implement any business logic in your database level, which can be done in any RDBMS system. Not every database fits every business need. That's why many companies rely on both relational and non-relational databases for different tasks. Although NoSQL databases have gained popularity for their speed and scalability, there are still situations in which a highly structured SQL database might be preferable. Some companies even use both SQL and NoSQL databases simultaneously. There are even other kind of databases like Neo4j, which is a graph database which can be used in social networks. We can debate about it in the future for sure. That's it for now. Let us know your opinion in the comments. We will update these debates every once in a while. If you like this video, don't forget to subscribe for more tech debates like this one.